Hello and welcome to the Church of Obelis. I am still alive. My internet is alive now as well, at least for now. So hopefully that it keeps that way. So it's been a while, a long while, but we'll play a bit of Dota today. We'll look at the patch. It's not even there, notifications. Previously had this in here as well. I guess we have to do it through the browser, but I think I'm going to play a game to warm up. I think we're gonna play an unranked game. Simply because I haven't played much recently. You see, my last game is like 10 days away, 10 days ago, and then I've played like a few games, but not very many. Recently, so I might be a little bit rusty, but hopefully we can. Like Laundry, of course, has been nerfed a little bit, but I think he's still okay. I think at least I think I'm still confident on him. So I think I should be okay. And yeah, then we'll talk about the patch later when people have had time to tune in. So, yeah, a lot has happened. I think the last stream has been in like early December, so it's been a while. So sorry about that situation. My internet has just been very unstable, and but hopefully it should be okay going forward. Yeah, I haven't really done too much Dota stuff. I've played some Stormgate, some single player games. Really liking Stormgate so far, even though it's obviously in an unfinished state, but I'm very hopeful about the future of that game. I made a video on that on the channel as well, a brief video giving my thoughts on Stormgate. Plan to do a bit more Stormgate stuff as well, but didn't really get around to it. But yeah, I think there's a bright future for that game. I haven't really, played too much Dota recently, but definitely, I think it's fun to get back into streaming again. Also watched like some shows. I've today actually watched a couple of episodes of the new Avatar: The Last Airbender show, which is surprisingly quite good so far. It's like very close to the original, so it's kind of not clear what the point even is, if they're just going to sort of remake the animated show without really changing much. But at least it's not bad. Should turn on live chat here to make sure that I don't miss any messages. And yeah, I also sort of semi-recently watched Three Body, the Chinese science fiction show based on the Three Body Problem book by Liu Xixian, which is of course like a great sort of modern classic of science fiction. And just like an excellent book, and the show is also really good, really faithful to the books. And it's actually available on YouTube to watch for free. So it's not dubbed, but it's like Chinese with subtitles available in English and some other languages. I really recommend that if you are into science fiction. Let's do some last hit practice, I suppose. Visage hasn't really changed, so we should still be good in both mid and off lane. Like Vlad is a little bit worse, but other than that, Visage is the same as ever.
Prepare for battle.
I also recently watched the first episode of what's it called, Shadow and Bone on Netflix. like a fantasy show, which is pretty good. It takes a little bit to sort of get into it. Like the first, I think like 2-3 episodes are like a little bit rough, but after that it really picks up its pace. I watched the first season so far. Hi there, Sean. Long time no stream. Indeed, it's been quite a long time. But I heard that they actually cancelled the show. There's only 2 seasons. But like, it's available on Netflix. It's like if you have like some time to kill, it's nice. I'd give the show like a, maybe like a 7 out of 10, maybe 8 out of 10. RIP Meepo. Didn't really look too much into what they changed about Meepo. I guess we'll get into that later. So I'm going to play a game first and then go into the patch notes. I guess Lemon doesn't want to play with us. The siege shall be soon. Any changes in Laundered Win Raid? Not really anything noticeable. Even gone up here. Yeah, so lower level laundry is obviously gonna be worse now. I think it's not too bad. Not sure if they really needed to nerf him again. Prepare for battle. Felt like the nerfs you already got were sufficient. But like, I've got enough experience with Laundry that I think I'm still fairly confident in playing him. It's gonna be a lot harder when you get run to like bad matchups. Since my hero pool is not that big, I typically second phase pick, so it can't really, it's hard to sort of pick Laundred into like the best Laundred games when you do that. You have to kind of get lucky to get a really good Laundred game. Like if I had a larger hero pool, I would be like comfortable kind of last picking. But I don't, what? Can I flick this? Thank you. So Sean, what have you been up to? Been me putting it up? Meepo's like one of these heroes that I always sort of wanted to learn, but I've never really gotten into it properly. Maybe with the changes now you're gonna be more incentivized to level up the bear over the Spirit Link. If you're not having big sustain problems with on your hero. The scaling is like a lot better now. It also scales the cooldown and the movement speed even more. Will I be reviewing Shkli's replay? I could do that. But not yet. First I'll play a game and review the patch and then maybe we'll get to that replay. Can people please actually be in the game? What is happening? Fresh haircut indeed. Got a haircut on... When was it? Friday, I think? Saturday? Didn't even read the patch. I read some of it. Your turn to ban.
Hmm. 5 seconds remaining.
No one going to come here? Holy shit.
Your turn to pick.
All right, let's do this.
10 seconds remaining.
Well, that's what I get for playing an unranked game. Do I care about winning? I do. Okay, so what do we buy here? We've got Slark. What's their offlane? Offlane is probably Ribbreaker Bounty, something like that. Let's do this, just be a bit bulky. Six Wraithbands is boomer shit. I don't really do six Wraithbands. You should do something like 4 or 5.
Chen, in your name. Yes.
It's prepare for battle. Bag.
You were doing very well. I'm very proud of you.
Doesn't do any at all.
It's in the bag.
I don't know, I feel like Wraithbands are really efficient. What's his reasoning for not doing them? I mean, obviously Wraithbands are slightly worse now.
Yes.
The patch, but I don't think it changes too much. But they're so low.
God willing. So I go.
How can this guy get caught? I'm kidding.
First blood. First blood. Bad and dead.
It's so bizarre.
A pious path.
Oh.
Execution starts now. God willing.
I don't get how you can caught as so get caught as a slug. Like, we saw them coming. You have full night vision. Okay.
Yes. Leap of faith. As you say.
And let's just do this on suspicion. No. Also nice to have their vision against the bounty. Shit, that was late there.
Yes.
It.
As Obelisk directs, false idolatry.
I'll block this for now.
May it please you.
Nice try.
Ooh.
Yes. In your name.
Alright, at least he's zoned. It was not worth it with the kill I got in the other lane. Alright. Didn't have that one. Okay.
God willing.
I think we just go for this.
A pious path.
Thanks.
Oh, okay. Not quite.
Attack.
What? Did not attack you?
As Obelisk directs. Yes.
Yeah, not quite.
God willing. Strength from on high. Schism. Repent. May it please you. Leap of faith.
Killing spree.
Yeah, that's really a good job. Okay, never mind. Kind of hard to give him a tango when he's hiding by the trees the entire time.
Fitting penance. Yes. So I go. As you said.
God.
In your name.
Okay. Oh, we have good creeps here. Nice.
Con el wombo combo perfecto.
Used with the spirit. Hallowed ground. In your name. I transcend. Yes.
Put one point here.
Obelisk, guide me.
Black is jungling. Okay.
Spree.
Test your faith.
Wait, something's wrong with my hotkeys.
Yes.
Dire structures are fortified.
May it please you.
Must have changed something in the settings or something. Something reset with the patch or something. Because my other unit hotkey is not working. Oh shit, I blocked this. Alright, that's this.
As you say.
Yeah. That's that. It's been a while since I actually played Chen.
Highest path.
Oh, my fucking hotkey's not working. It's annoying.
Okay, where is... Where is my select other units thing? Ah, I can't find it right now. I'll just go here for XP. Alright, let's get the newly buffed Kobold with lots of extra bonus damage.
So I go.
Let's let him have level 6.
Mega kill!
Hallowed ground.
Much damage.
Yes. As you say, my faithful join.
Okay, by charging in.
Yes.
He's gonna be level 6.
In your name, Obelisk, guide me.
I'll sit here for a little bit. Oh, we could have stacked here. Too late now. Ah, I keep using my hotkey. Go back to being. That's my level 5 at least.
A pious path. Faith is rewarded. Yes.
Attack. Yeah.
As you said.
Also space for me, not complaining about that. Alright, nice.
Your top tower.
Oh, I'm not getting it.
As Obelisk directs.
Okay, let's get some level 5 creeps.
In your name.
And not from here. There we go. This is not working either. Hotkey.
My thrift rewarded.
Charged.
God willing. Yes.
Haste.
Ah. He wanted to use that circumflex key. Ooh. Ah, too late, fuck. God, nothing is clicking here. Not quite.
So I go.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
Oh. In your name. Maybe I shouldn't have picked Chen for the first game in 10 days. Now we're pushing this tower, I guess. Maybe respawn in a few seconds anyway. I thought it was just a sentry, but I had to make sure. Alright, it's good, it's good.
Your entrails festoon my horde,
unwilling.
Your top tower is under attack.
In your name.
There's a EA here.
Obelisk, guide me.
I hate that my circumflex key's not working. All passive creeps. Maybe that's what I have to do. Maybe all passive hero next game.
Your judgment comes.
Ah, my hotkeys.
Yes. Attack.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
Oof. I mean, we got double Midas. No, we don't. He's going for Midas, though.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Leap of faith.
Dire structures are fortified.
Okay.
As you say.
I can't catch up to him. Oh, there we go.
Your middle tower is under attack.
Nice. We get more here. Okay, using up all my stuff. Now I think I get a wolf from here.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
That's a nice passive creep.
In your name. Worthy donation. As you say.
Okay. There you go, Vlads. Go, Vlads. I just took one.
I'm not sure I can use it.
We'll get the next one.
Even more.
Yeah.
I didn't really expect to it would do anything here, but you know. I still keep trying to use the circumflex thing. It also doesn't work for here. Where's that hotkey? Other units. Where is that? There it is.
Killing spree.
Resurrected.
Okay. Good Vlads.
I'll take that.
The enemy's middle tower has fallen. Your top tower is under attack.
Nothing happening there, so we'll TP here.
Leap of faith.
God willing.
I keep forgetting that I have E as an active. Oh, my pen has... Ah, shit. I'm really playing bad this game so far. Yeah, neutral item hotkey. Not there either. Not the way that hotkey disappeared. This is gonna be relevant soon. This part of the map. We even get some creeps, but XP wasting here. XP. I don't want to give it up. Your bottom tower is under increased attack. Though.
Yes. My block increases. May it please you.
Right, this has been farmed. I'm just gonna put this here.
As you say.
Your middle tower is under attack. And now my husky works actually. Okay. I did something in this game.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
I've been farming a bit. Near this. Right. Add them to TP.
Up higher's pass. Leap of faith.
Maybe that's a bit redundant.
Yes. Say your prayers.
Get a decent creep here. Maybe that's also an aura. Repositioning might be nice. Okay, stuff happening here. Today, on top.
Yes. May it please you.
We have better tier 2 items. Yes.
Obelisk, guide me.
Let me just go Holy Locket. Nothing fancy. I think if we just farm a bit, it's okay. We could double Midas. Lina is also gonna scale pretty good. Theo obviously also gonna scale, but
invisibility.
Grove bow.
So I go.
The full whip. Keep forgetting to use Divine Favor active.
That should help.
Yes. Okay, yeah, I can't help there. How did this not work? Oh my god. As you say. I was a bit late there in the ancient camp. Ah! I should have used ult. Panicked there a bit. To be honest. Okay. Well, I mean, this guy did good work. Well, that's the wolf that he wanted. No, doesn't matter. I have ult now. I'll probably just bot back for that fight.
So I go.
Your middle tower is under attack.
That's not great.
Hallowed ground.
Radiant structures are fortified. Your middle tower is under attack.
Leap of faith. In your name. My faithful join me. A pious path. May it please
Akina.
My block increases.
It's an aura.
In your name.
I'll take that. Ground.
Obelisk, guide me. So I go.
MKB, that seems fine.
God willing.
Getting some nice money from the stacks.
Chastised. As Obelisk directs.
Nope. There's no way of doing that. I don't understand these TPs though. They're just like reflexive.
A pious path. Compelled. As you say.
But like if they just like do a small gang with like four people and get a kill there, even on our carry, that's it's like not even that bad.
Consecrated.
But if they do that and we also get and they also get 2 TPs from that, then it's really bad.
Leap of faith. Yes. So I go. Obelisk, guide me.
Your middle tower.
Maybe not necessary. Okay. Nice. bottom. Maybe get a tier 1. Maybe not.
In your name. Yes. A pious path. As Obelisk.
You can take. I should have taken the bubble there.
Oh, you're hot.
God willing. In your name.
He's not nearby to take this. Probably doesn't want it either anymore.
I send you home. So I go.
Okay. Nope.
May it please you.
I tried though.
Leap of faith.
This guy maybe can be pushing out something.
As Obelisk directs. A pious path. May it please you. As you say,
Roshan has fallen into the dark.
Leap of faith.
Okay.
Yes.
Let's go there.
So I go.
Oh my god, they're everywhere.
A pious path.
Ooh.
Your top tower is under attack.
No. Maybe I've lured her in far enough, but probably not. Actually, yeah. It's the Aegis. That was a BKB. Nice. I did something this game. Because I am deceptively tanky. Give me something good. It's all not that great. Oh my god, it's all pretty bad. What do we get now? Do we have a drum or something?
Yes.
Maybe that'll help. Maybe I need Solar Crest.
I almost feel bad.
There.
As you say.
I think a single target save is important here. I'll get.
Hallowed ground.
my god. I took a D ward. Hey, 20 gold. Seems fair. Oh my god. Alright. I don't think this game is really doable anymore. Yeah, let's go for Spoiler Crest. We'll have enough for Pavise.
May it please you.
Your middle tower you is under attack.
Obelisk, guide me.
Keep buying time, at least.
Radiant structures are fortified. Your middle tower is under attack. Your middle tower has fallen.
Hallowed ground. Yes.
Your top tower is under attack.
So I go.
Radiant structures are fortified. Your top tower is under attack.
And we're gonna have really good single target defense now. Solar Crest, Divine Favor, and Holy Locket. This is pretty over. Yeah, I just played pretty badly at the start because of hotkeys and because of just rustiness. But I feel like towards the later stages of the game, I sort of got into it better and played okay. But of course, then was already too late. Ah, we got something. Even got chat credit for the kill. Ooh. Wait, I already devoted one ward. What?
Obelisk, guide me.
That's the second one.
Obelisk infuses me. Yes.
May it please. I don't see any wards here. Yet vision somewhere.
As you say, persuaded by
prayer. Okay. Yeah, the spear has a lot of stuff. No Defu Gaming. Wasn't Defu like pretty much a must buy on Slark? I mean, I guess they nerfed it a little bit, but still. Maybe because he like had a bad start and so he decided to go for the Midas. Okay, maybe they will extend. Okay. Yeah, we're not even getting anyone low. Blue buyback. And finish my item. I'm gonna sold my settlers probably. This way I'm 6 slotted. What was that hook? I guess he was looking for the fishy boy. Let's talk about the patch. Your middle tower is under attack. The enemy now has mega creeps. Yeah. You need to switch over here. Hold on a second. We'll do this. There we go. That should do it. All right. This is the gameplay update 735C. I'm assuming the game is over now. Yeah. Okay. Game is over. There we go. 735C patch review. So we have got some changes to the neutral creeps, a bit more damage to the kobolds. This camp is going to be a little bit harder to do. And also this matters if you're like pulling small camp, you do a bit more damage now to creeps. For like Chen and stuff, it's not going to matter whether your kobold does 3 damage more or less. That is hardly relevant. Cultural Priest no longer casts heal when first attacked, making it easier to stack and to pull. That's good. And Ogre Bruiser now only casts Smash when it's below 70% health. So yeah, that's also going to make it much easier to pull the Ogre camp for melee heroes. That was like a problem with melee heroes, that it was really difficult to pull this Ogre camp. So those are all good changes. I like it. Helm of Iron Will gets slight nerf. It was like a really good build-up item, so it makes sense. Venom gets cheaper. Not sure why they need to do that. This also presumably means that the Orb of Corrosion gets cheaper, unless they change other components. So, and I think Orb of Corrosion was already pretty good. Let's see if the other components also changed. No. Okay, so it's just Orb of Corrosion, 25 gold cheaper. Very efficient item. Obviously not the best for farming. So if you're like behind in the lane, you don't want to go Orb of Corrosion. But it's like really good on any sort of melee right clicker if you're having a good game. Talisman of Evasion now is 20% evasion. I like that because that was like a really, really bad component. 15% evasion is just not very much. So 20% is a lot more noticeable. Seems good. Voodoo Mask, spell lifesteal regeneration against heroes and creeps increased from 10.2 to 12 and 12.4. All right. So Voodoo Mask, a better component. Of course, with the recent nerfs to the spell damage stuff that we got in the B patch, that makes sense. Give Voodoo Mask a little bit extra power. Because like for like a week or so, we had like really strong spell damage stuff. Like Leshrac was really good and stuff, but then they nerfed it immediately. So giving the spell damage heroes a bit back makes sense. BKB now has 60% magic resistance. Okay, so much for the spell damage heroes. I'm fine with that. Doesn't matter too much. The most important part of BKB, of course, is still gonna be the spell immunity. That's the most important part. And then we've got Bloodstone. Change to the recipe now requires Void Stone and gives plus 3 mana regen. Okay, this item after they nerfed it to the ground has just been not really bought by almost anyone. So it makes sense to give it some good buff. Bloodthorn. Total cost decreased by 200. Two orchid changes. Solrent extra damage on hit decreased from 60 to 50. I feel like that's a good change. There were like some heroes where this Solrent extra damage was just like ridiculous. Maybe they should have just instead changed it to have like 60 for heroes and like 30 or something for other stuff. Because like it's just like really good on illusion heroes and on like certain heroes that have like summons, like Envisage for example. But for most heroes, like for like normal like right click heroes, 60 damage per hit this late in the game is not that big of a deal. So I think I would have preferred it if they had done some sort of change to make like summons and illusions do less damage from Bloodthorn hits. Dagon now has 15% lifesteal across the board. And the cooldown is also decreased. Okay, so level 1 Dagon gets a lot better from this. That's kind of cool. It's also important because this is, you can, you know, with the changes that they made in, what is it, like 733 or something, where you can one-shot creeps with Dagon and that get lifesteal from that as well. Dagon is also like a... not like a good farming item, but like you can use it to farm. And now that has less cooldown. And you get more life back. That's pretty cool. Defu gets a slight nerf, now has a bit of for mana cost. Hold on 1 second. I get that new tea. All right, where were we? So Defu nerf, I think seems perfectly fair. 25 mana is not very much. So it's not gonna affect too much, I think. But then of course Disperser, upgrade from Defu, gets a bit of a nerf as well. So an extra 400 cost. And Suppress no longer an AoE, but instead affects the target and the user. Okay, so this is going to make it actually better when you're chasing people in some situations, but it's just no longer an item that also helps the rest of your team as well. It's going to make it easier to use, and sort of the floor is better, but the ceiling is a lot lower. So I'm fine with this change. I don't think this person really ever needed to be in AoE. Now you have to make some decisions, like, you know, do I want to slow down the enemy or dispel the enemy, or do I want to speed up my ally or dispel my ally? And you're always going to dispel yourself, which is cool. So I actually like those changes. This person was a little bit too strong, so these changes, I think, seem fair. I think really good introduces nerf here. Then we've got Eternal Shroud, gets 50 less health. Yeah, this item was like a little bit overtuned, just gave you so much tankiness with all the HP it gave you. So this makes sense. I like it. It also makes, like, relative to it, makes Pipe better, because Pipe was a bit overshadowed now by Eternal Shroud. Gleipnir has a 200 less gold recipe cost. Yeah, you didn't really see many people buy Gleipnir these days. So I'm fine with changing it a little bit. And it's going to make a hero like Lina, for example, stronger. And if you do like right-click Lina, you buy Maelstrom for farming and for like general damage. And then Gleipnir is generally the more attractive upgrade. Heart of Taraz gets an extra 5 strength. Okay, so a couple of months ago we had the patch where everyone went hard. So now they nerfed hard quite a bit, and now no one went hard, and now they've given an extra 5 strength. So let's see how it goes. I feel like we might get into another meta of lots of people buying hearts, but we'll see. But yeah, previously the item was just a little bit sad, so I'm fine with this. Heaven's Halberd is 50 gold cheaper and gets an extra 5% evasion bonus and health regen and lifesteal amp bonus increased. Yeah, I haven't really seen much Heaven's Halberd lately. The big change was that you can now like get out of Heaven's Halberd by BKB. Like, you're not affected. So even if they get Heaven's Halberd before you start BKB, you're not gonna be disarmed while BKB is active. So that might Heaven's Halberd a lot weaker, and now we're getting a lot of buffs here. I feel like this might be a bit of an overbuff, because now it gives like really good stats. Like, what are, where's Heaven's Halberd? So it's only 3.5k, and it gives you 20 strength, 25 evasion. You basically get like a stats from Sanj plus a little bit, and 25% evasion. That's pretty good. That's pretty solid stats. I think it's an item you're gonna see more on like tanky offlaner kind of heroes. But of course it's still gonna be like situational if you need to disarm someone. If you're playing against something like Luna, for example, right? She's fairly low range, so you can cast it on her with that cast range. But she's ranged, so it's gonna be affected for 5 seconds. Luna, of course, is going to have BKB, but she's not always going to have BKB. So, Heaven's Halberd, I think, and against a hero like that, is going to be very attractive. Or, you know, something like a Huska, for example. Whereas if you play against these like long-range heroes, like a Sniper or Drow or something like that, Heaven's Halberd is not as good because you need to get close enough to cast it first. And like if you're a tanky offlaner and you're in range of a Drow or a Sniper, the Sniper or the Drow will want to get away from you rather than attack you most of the time. So against those, Heaven's Halberd is still not going to be that great. But, you know, 25% evasion is no joke. Helm of the Overlord gets a decent buff. That's 375 gold off. Never mind, 475. That's a pretty hefty reduction. It's still, of course, a very expensive item. And with no longer incorporating the Vlads, it's, you know, not an item that is like gonna be that widely used. I feel like it's still just gonna be like Beastmaster and Lycan to consider this item. It gives a ton of all stats, which is decent on these heroes. I feel like a Beastmaster right click is not really a thing, but Lycan is like a decent right clicker. You can get like Helm of the Overlord, gives you decent right click stats as well. Which is nice with like the crits you get and such. But still, this is going to remain a niche item. I think they need to buff the Helm of the Dominator. I feel like that item especially is pretty weak. Aya gets 50 gold cheaper. I think like all the Kaya Ascension and the Yasha is going to get 50 gold cheaper. Total cost decreased. Okay, spell life amp decreased as well. But spell amplification bonus increased. Okay, so it's more and more about spell amp and less about the spell life amplification. So overall, definitely a buff. But, you know, not quite as much spell life steal. To be honest, spell life steal is always a stat that I have never really liked. I feel like it's it just leads to sort of broken stuff where either you sort of spell life stealing a shit ton and you're like unkillable, or it's just pretty useless. I feel like there's not much middle ground there. And like that sort of middle ground is where it's interesting. So I don't really like spell life steal items being strong. So I'm happy with those changes. Aya Senge has okay, that was 50 gold less because the components are cheaper. Get 25 instead of 20 status assist, which is quite a big bonus. You get less spell life steal. Okay, makes sense. And then do you get more health regen and life steal amp bonus? Yeah, so definitely a decent buff. Yeah, that's Kaya and Sanj, and then Kanda gets Empower spell base damage increased from 100 to 150. Okay, I feel like Kanda's item doesn't really have a home on many heroes. It's a kind of like a weird concept. Then we got Mage Slayer. Recipe cost increased, now it's 400 gold, total cost increased, also by 200. Now only has 20% magic resist, debuff damage per second increased from 20 to 25. Duration decreased from 6 seconds to 3 seconds. Okay. So you can still sort of use it as like a farming tool in the early game where you sort of tap every creep once. Now you have to renew it every 3 seconds instead of 6 seconds, but still, pretty good. And the DPS is higher. If you keep hitting someone, it does more damage now. But it's going to wear off sooner, also means people can blink 3 seconds sooner. Because previously you could just attack someone and disable their blink for 9 seconds, which is pretty strong. Now it's only 6 seconds. Yeah, so this means that it's no longer quite as much of a, like a double counter to magic damage users. It's still going to be strong against spell damage dealers, but it's no longer going to be quite as good. And of course, some spell damage dealers are not even doing magic damage. Like Mage Slayer is like still a good counter against stuff like Bristleback or Timbersaw that do physical or pure damage. So, yeah, what this will do basically is that it's no longer, Mage Slayer is no longer like always a good item. It's more like a situational counter item, which is, I think, appropriate. But against certain heroes, it's like going to be really strong. So I like those changes. Manta style. Okay, 50 gold less because of Yasha. Meteor Hammer is now cheaper. All right, I feel like I never see Meteor Hammer, so why not? Okay, MKB gets cheaper. There's also been some buffs to evasion, so buffing MKB makes sense. Counteract those items. Nullifier, more projectile speed. Okay. Yeah, 1100 is pretty slow, so I'm not complaining there. Seems reasonable. Overcorrosion, we already talked about, is a bit cheaper now. Orchid now gets 200 cheaper and no nerfs. Ooh, that's a pretty nifty buff. Ooh. Yeah, that seems pretty good. Maybe Orchid Rush now on Visage? Perhaps? Because Bloodthorn, of course, is still really good. It's been nerfed a little bit, only 50 damage per hit now, but it's cheaper, so maybe. We've got Parasma now has a 400 gold recipe. Gold cost increased. Int bonus decreased. Okay. Was that item really that strong? What is that item right now? Parasma, where is it even? That's the Kanda. Where's Parasma? Oh, the magical? No, it's here as support, okay. These categories are so weird. How is it a support item? That makes no sense. I guess just because they want to have like a nice a rectangle there for every category. but this is not a support item. Not sure if this nerf's really warranted. I don't think I've ever really bought this item, to be honest. Anyway. Then we have Radiance, also get some more evasion. Alright, nice. Radiance, I think, is not a very strong item right now, so this buff makes sense. It's in line with the changes to the other evasion stuff, with the talisman now being giving 5% more evasion. Then we have Revenant's Brooch. Mana cost decreased by 25 and no longer consumes mana for attacks generated by abilities. Okay, those are some really good changes. Because like if you, for example, bought this on something like Medusa, you know, you might just shoot through any entire mana. Like, not like we'd ever buy this on Medusa, but like, what are some items, some heroes that generate extra attacks? Or like on something like a... like a dagger, for example, from PA would no longer cost the extra mana there, or like a Hoodwink with her Acorn Shot and stuff like that. Okay. Also, I think with like Drow Aghanims, you would also cost extra mana, which now no longer costs. So I think these are good changes. Like 75 per hit was always a bit expensive. I think this is good. Senge, okay, we already basically had this, 50 gold less, but actually more status resistance. Okay, so like a straight buff for Senge. Senge and Yasha was 100 gold cheaper, and more status resist and more health and life amp. I don't really see much Senge in Yasha these days, so I'm not, I don't have a problem with these changes. Shiva's Guard now costs 350 more, and one less armor, one less attributes, one less health. Yeah, so basically Shiva is no longer OP. Is it weak now? I'm not sure, but definitely not an item you always want to buy. Vayle also gets a nerf. Seems fair. It might be a bit of an over nerf. Nothing weird like that. And she was as well. But we'll see. Vlad's now is less good of an aura item. Basically, some of these aura benefits are now rolled into just benefiting the wearer. So you, as the one who has Vlad's, you still get the same bonuses, but your team gets less bonuses. You lose 2 armor and 0.75 mana region. The mana region is not that important. You don't stick close to your teammates all the time, so this it's not going to matter too much. But the armor is definitely going to hurt. So Vlad is one of these items where it's like a delicate balance between making the item so good that you also want to have one on your team, versus making it so bad that you never buy it. Maybe they struck the right balance now. We'll see. It's like the problem with Vlad is still it's a dead end item. So I feel like this might put the item back into the garbage can, because there's like a lot of items that do sort of similar things. You would buy on sort of similar heroes. Like it competes with stuff like a drum, for example. It competes with stuff like mech, with stuff like Solar Crest, and now this item might be overshadowed. These alternatives. Wraithband gets light nerf. I think that's fair. Wraithband has long been like a really good compared to the other ones, especially compared to Null Talisman. So a slight nerf here seems fair. Yasha, of course, 50 gold cheaper, and then Yasha and Kaya, 100 gold cheaper, and less spell life steal amp. Okay, makes sense. Neutral changes, I'm not going to go through all of those. Arcane Ring gets another nerf? Really? Wasn't that good to begin with. Red Trinket, nerf makes sense. Occult Bracelet makes sense too. Safety Bubble, yeah, why not? They keep buffing the Shovel. The Shovel, I feel like, is already really good. Not sure why they keep... buffing that. Bullwhip now a little bit less bonuses, but it no longer interrupts movement, which is a pretty big deal. Makes it a lot more pleasant to use on yourself. Although, to be fair, it is a whip. Maybe it should be a bit unpleasant. But yeah, good change. Specialist Array, of course, well-deserved nerf. That item was pretty overpowered, even with the slight nerfs you already got. Craggy Coat, more armor. Yeah, you never really see this item, so okay, why not buff it? And then some changes to tier 5 items. Who cares? You never get this anyway in like 95% of games. All right, hero changes. Abba has more cooldown on his ultimate. Okay. Not going to change too much. Although, you know, 60 seconds out of 50, that is going to change a little bit. Arc Warden, some nerfs. So this is not that bad, but this is bad. You know, going from 45 seconds to 16 seconds, that's a huge nerf. Like when you're casting this in combat, 16 seconds is an eternity in combat, but you could get like a lot of map control and vision with these. But now it's 16 seconds, that's so little. That's really gonna hurt Arc Warden. Henry is back. Welcome back, Henry. Batrider gets a Flame Break Radius nerf. Okay, why not? It's not gonna change too much. Chaos Knight gets a little bit more pull distance. Okay. Well, you know, 50-50 range is not gonna... It's not nothing. Chen, Divine Favor now costs mana, 75 mana. Making it like a lot a lot less viable in lane. Later on in the game, you don't really care too much about 75 mana, but early on, 75 mana can hurt a bit. So, depending on how you're doing on mana, you might want to skip Divine Favor, although it's strong enough that you probably still want to get one point in it early. And then Penitence damage decreased from 225 to 175. Yeah, this talent was already not that great, but, you know, the other level 10 talent is also pretty bad, so you probably still go for this. They might just give 10 some decent level 10 talent instead. This is not going to change too much. The 10 items are still good. Albeit the Vlad is slightly worse, but yeah, I think it's not going to change too much. Death Prophet gets less movement speed. Okay. 4% across all levels. Seems like a fair nerf. Doom. Right. There's all nerfs, right? Yeah, a bunch of nerfs to Doom. Yeah, it's like a very, just use like a very solid offlaner, so it makes sense to give him some nerfs. Dragon Knight, Elder Dragon from Frostbreath, movement slow decreased. Okay, so it's 40 to 30 and 60 to 45. That's gonna make the Aghanims especially worse. It's like 60% is a lot of slow. But from 60 to 45, that's a big deal. And then the attack slow, similar deal there. I can see a replay. And then also, yeah, so the Aghanim is going to be a lot worse. And also, like, level 3 ultimate is worse. Just as Dragonite came back into the meta. Ember Spirit gets slightly more mana cost on Stellar Fist. This is a spell you spam, so even 5 mana does matter, but it's not a huge nerf. Enigma gets less cast range on Malefic. People are playing Enigma these days. Heroes, Enigma. We had pretty high win rate. No one really picking him, but I guess. Don't do this to me. Here we go. Void, one of the strongest carries, gets one less base armor. Time dilation, cooldown, progression slow decreased. Alright, so we get less slow. And time lock no longer has a bonus duration against creeps. Okay, it doesn't matter too much, I think. Honestly, for such a strong carry, these are pretty mild nerfs. Probably not gonna really knock Faces Ward off his pedestal. And we've got Hoodwink, who gets slightly less slow duration. All right, minor nerf, why not? Leshra gets a bit more damage on Diabolic Edict, one per level. And then Pulse Nova activation cost decreased on lower levels. Okay, so helping out Leshra a little bit after he was nerfed to the ground. Makes sense. Lion gets more cooldown on Earth Spike and Mana Drain. Movement, slower bonus decreased. Okay, 5 across the board. Aghanim Shard resistance decreased. Bonus break distance decreased. And breaks on secondary targets of Lion loses vision of them. Okay. I feel like Mana Drain was just like a really annoying ability. I feel like they never should have given it slow, but at least it's a bit less now. Lone Druid now has a lot worse of a bear at level 1. You lose 40 movement speed, you lose 30 second cooldown on resummon. But once you're up to level 4, it's basically back to normal. You just lose 10 movement speed, which is not that big of a deal. But it's definitely going to hurt the laning stage, and it's going to especially make Lone Druid a much worse offlaner. Because in the offlane, you just don't get levels as quickly. And your bear just tends to take more damage because there's two heroes there, so having the higher resummon cost is more of a problem. So you can compensate for this by buying more TPs in difficult lanes where your bear takes lots of damage. But I feel like for mid lone druid, it's not going to make a huge difference. But then we have the change to the Jingo Mastery, now again affecting the bear. Apparently this was a bug, but it's like it's kind of funny how they have these things that they apparently consider bugs, but then they're in the game for months and months and don't get changed. Like when they first changed the bear to have attributes, being a universal hero, it was affected by Jingo Mastery. Then they made some like bug fixes, and then it no longer was affected by Jingo Mastery. And it's been like that for, I don't know, like half a year or something. Yeah, I don't know. But it's definitely going to make the matchup against Monkey King a lot harder. Before this, Lone Druid was kind of like a counter against Monkey King. But now, it's going to be much harder. Especially in lane. Magnus. Fix interactions between Skewer and other forced movement abilities. Causing Skewer to deal damage relative to the distance between the target and the center of the map. What? So is this now the new behavior, or is it the buggy old behavior that they fixed? I think that's the buggy old behavior. But it should not deal damage relative to the distance between the target and the center of the map. That's insane. Alright, also cooldown reduction decreased. And okay, so we're nerfing the talents a little bit. Okay. Mostly bug fixes, that not going to change too much. Meepo. So Sean has complained earlier about killing Meepo. So now Dig has less health restore from 35 to 25, and stats gained from other Meepos decreased from 50% to 40%. Okay, so the Agnes and Shard have both been nerfed. And of course also the nerfed Dispersor. Because it being AoE was like a really big deal on Meepo. Now that's no longer AoE, that item is a lot worse on Meepo. You probably still buy it. Because it's like the highest agility item in the game, and Sifu is good. But it's going to be a lot worse. But Meepo has been really strong in pubs, so makes sense to nerf him. Nature's Prophet gets 3 less base damage. Sprout damage per second rescaled. No, 25 at level 1 and 70 at level 4. Okay. The level 1 is worse, but level 2 is the same, and level 3 and 4 are better. It no longer lingers for 0.5 seconds after leaving the AoE. Okay, so that's definitely a nerf if you take that into account. Also, the cooldown and teleport increased again. Yeah, I don't feel Prophet is going to be that good after this patch. I think the hero's already been nerfed enough. Okay, Omni-Knight, repel not correctly, nullifies pure damage. Okay. OD, Agnum Scepter max mana as damage barrier decreased from 75 to 70%. Okay, slight nerf there. Not going to be the biggest of deals. EA gets a slight buff to Agi gain and a bit more cast range on Dagger at a level, still going to make her laning stage a bit better. And it's going to make the late game slightly better, but it's not a big change. Doesn't really matter too much. Then we got Slark. Pounce cooldown increased. Okay, 2 seconds more at max level. At all levels, actually. Then Terrorblade. Who said this was a democracy? Weren't you the one who was so adamant about I have to review this patch on stream, otherwise the world is going to end? Okay, we've got Terrorblade, a bit more base strength, and Reflect cooldown decreased, so nice buffs to Terrorblade. Like the hero is still pretty hard to play in pubs, but maybe we're going to see more in the pro scene. Timber, Flamethrower gets nerfed a bit, and the level 15 talent nerfed. Okay, not going to change too much. Vengeful Spirit, more cooldown on Magic Missile. And Wave of Terror, damage decreased. Okay, so those are some decent nerfs. Venge definitely a very powerful hero, so makes sense to get some nerfs. Viper, Nether Toxin, max DPS decreased. So from level 150 to 35 is of course a big difference. But it's only the max DPS. So this is more like about farming, because like actual opponents are not going to stand there for the full duration. Definitely going to make it quite a bit worse than farming at the start. Then we've got Corrosive Skin, max range radius decreased. Okay, 1200 instead of 1400. Makes sense, like most auras. And Witch Doctor Agrim is no longer has True Strike. Yeah, I like that. Okay, that is the patch. A lot of small changes, obviously, it's just a letter patch. Unfortunately, some nerfs to Chen and to Lone Druid. But I think that's in okay shape. Why do I care about coughing into my sleeve inside my own house? Doesn't make much of a difference. I don't want to wear a mask on stream, no. I wouldn't want to deprive you of my beautiful face. All right. Let us, I suppose, review Henry's replay. Seven, five, zero, two, eight, three, two, two, five, three. Yeah, small camper and pull is going to be a little bit easier with the cobalt. Because three damage across all these cobalts does add up. Alright, let's change the scene here in OBS. Okay, who are we playing? We are playing Abba. Okay, looks like offlane Abba. Pretty normal starting items. Let's discover together what happens in this game. So okay, we're getting good damage, that's good. Oh, are we carry Abba? Or are we just gonna TP? No. Okay, I guess carry Abba. Oh yeah, okay, we have Ragnar in the offlane. Okay, I mean wand. Do we need a wand in this lane? You see, I was not gonna cast that many spells. Like, we want a wand eventually to clean up those branches, but it's not an item we really wanna rush here, I think. I think we should be looking to dominate this lane. Like, Silence is a pretty good good lane partner, but he doesn't have good disable, only slow, so maybe Overvenom is more higher priority here. I think Corrosion is like really good on Abba. With this hero, you really want to dominate your lane. Bully your opponents. Both the enemy heroes are rather slow, so you can run them down. Ooh, I don't know if that's that important here. But of course, also a good item. But I feel like the Venom is the higher priority here. But he had enough gold, he could probably just bought boots and venom. Okay. We get the kill, we die, that's fine. Grimms are really gonna disappear from this game. Oops. We'll get those CS at least. Okay, that's good trading. Using our shield. Okay, everything good so far, but I really would like to see Old Corrosion here. So we're down a player though. Maybe that's where Henry submitted this game, because being proud of winning 4 vs 5. Okay, we're going Radiance. Normally not a big fan of Radiance on Abba, but I guess if you're playing 4 vs 5, I can see it. Because we're going to need some wave push.
middle tower.
It's sinking, just like yours.
All right, that's good. Not quite. Oh shit, we had to pop the ultimate. That was not ideal. But it's still old patch, so low cooldown.
Is under pressure. Dire's middle tower is drowning.
It was not the ideal for what was happening here.
Dire's middle tower is
taking so much damage from these creeps.
Just got knocked down.
Ultimate is back. What? Ready? Oh yeah, it just came back. Alright. Yeah.
Radiant's bottom tower faces a stiff wind.
Alright, I guess we're just gonna farm our Radiance. Being proud of hitting forward is 5. You mean like the enemy team? Unpausing? What do you mean by that? Alright, you got our second relic. Yeah, we just want to farm our Radiance now. New patch, these camps are a lot less annoying. Okay, I guess we got our own Ovenom substitute. Our
courier.
I mean, right now it's a bit of a hot combat zone here, but we should be sending our courier out anyway. We can probably still buy here and yeah, walking there. I mean, I guess it works. Yeah, you're forced to use the ultimate pretty early there, as you walk to the shop. Yeah, just like definitely good practice to always try to send the courier.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Oh, nice stack here. You have no ultimate, so you're probably gonna die here. I get this general kill though.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Okay, so in a game like this where you're 4 versus 5, can't really go for the team fights. Actually, no, he's back now. Oh, he's back now. He's just like has more net worth. He's still playing. Okay, I guess. Like, generally, if you are in a 4-5 game, you want to buy more like farming oriented items. Like Boots of Travel is like really strong. Game probably hard because I went noob Radiance. Yeah, I don't like Radiance generally, but I think here it's okay because you were 4 versus 5.
Radiance bottom tower is under attack.
Oh, I said you might have submitted this replay because you were proud of winning 4 versus 5.
Is under attack. Radiance bottom tower faces a stiff wind. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, Radiance generally not good on ABBA. You just want to play like as like a tempo hero, and Radiance just delay is only timing so much. And I mean, new patch Radiance a little bit better, but then so is Manta, 50 gold cheaper. Yeah, we're pretty far behind. But of course, to be expected when you're playing down one player for quite a long time. Minus 50 gold. Yeah, of course, not the most important change, but yeah, it's something. Obviously, the 5% evasion is a bit better than that. We're going for phase boots now. I don't know, bit of a weird order. I feel like either you have to go. Okay, it's not going to work. Because like this is not a very efficient item. So either you go phase boots first and then you finish. Like you just go phase boots and then you start your Manta, or you get Manta and then you get phase boots. I think I just phase boots first, though, is better. Yeah, this is not gonna work. You just have no damage. It's like, you got a Radiance. The Torment does not gonna care too much about that. Keep trying to do this though. Okay, we need to at least look what's happening there. If we can TP there. Game doesn't let you mute things, yes. Middle tower is under attack. Let's just spam thing to annoy them until they did it. What is it? Alright, finally we're TPing in there, good. Don't chase. He's gonna die. I turned around just in time, this guy's gonna die though. Oh, Torment Roshan, yeah. It's really weird. Sometimes you have these teams that just don't want to do Tormentor like ever. Other times I have these games where like I'm playing Lone Root, I can just easily solo Tormentor, but like they just don't let me solo Tormentor. They always just want to come here. And then there's like this one plus five who like throws one spell out there and does like 20 damage and almost dies. Finally, the tormenting. Good. All right, need to defend here. Question though is, can we defend? Does Pud mean flank them like it's Gaza? I'm not exactly sure. What that's supposed to mean. Alright, that's like a good punish. He's sort of running around headlessly. But yeah, you couldn't really push the mid tower there. Probably head towards top. So Manta illusions don't last that long. I don't think they're gonna do that much if you send them across such distance. Yeah, like they arrived here and like 2 seconds later they timed out. Not really worth. Yeah, your team should not be down there. You should not be down here either. Should be top. The blink dagger now. All right. Okay, Pudge is a bit of an edge lord. Don't really love the blink dagger here. Like something like Harpoon is better. It also offers a bunch of tankiness and damage. Because like right now you don't really do that much damage. Not that tanky. But yeah, they just keep going like it's really stupid high grounds. That's how you throw games. Easy kill.
Dire are standing for enemies.
I don't know, but probably in PUBG you just need to like never go high ground unless you have like a huge advantage. And even then you also still have to be careful about how you go high ground. Not sure what Invoker is trying to do there. They're taking a pretty bad fight there. The Tundra is a pretty good team. Okay, now we're going for Harpoon. Taking some damage on our structures, but it's okay. The stage is all about just getting the net worth back. We're not top net worth, that's something. What does Wraithing have? Alright, some decent items. We are hiding down here. Ooh, almost. Yeah, I guess against Prophet it's pretty important to keep the Quelling Blade. You could even just update the blink dagger now. You want to actually manually activate borrow time here in the thing like that. You don't have to go back to the fountain. This is last patch, that's only 50 second cooldown. They again go for a very ill-advised high ground push. We're going for Kanda. Is that great on Abba? I mean, yeah, I mean it works well together with Miscall, but doesn't seem that great. I think actually upgrading the Blink Dagger is the best choice here. Well, I suppose with Harpoon we have like a bit of a counter to Sprout. I think you should probably actually should have casted Manta here in the middle and pushed out middle. There's not many people around. It's definitely risky. You don't really have vision of them. You don't move this quick either. Okay, this is going to work out. You don't want it? I guess. Yeah, it's probably bad on her. Did you get last Roshan as well? It only rolls if the team gets Roshan second time in a row, right? Or did I misinterpret that change? Okay, so I'm trying to go on to the Wraith King, and of course doesn't have Pokemon anymore. It rolls every time. Really?
Dire's bottom tower is about.
Okay, so we've got a lot of money in the bank. I suppose you want to keep the Quelling Blade as long as possible. It makes sense, but now we should buy it. I played some games since then. Not very many. Oh, he didn't use TP scroll, he used his regular teleport. Was it on cooldown? Yeah, it was on cooldown, okay. What even does a shard do? Deals attack damage and impact. Increases the base slow, okay. Doesn't seem that great, but it's like a decent luxury item, so it makes sense to buy it at this point and not earlier.
Bounty.
Regeneration. Bottom tower. Yeah, at this stage you're in pretty good shape.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Amazing with 25 talent. Oh yeah, okay. That's true. Blood. definitely helps with those skeletons. Yep, should be using it, obviously.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Islands. Go on the invo. Not think disabled. It's better to blink behind him. But it works out either way. Saving for the fights and not using in the fights. Like now, for example. They used the shield instead. Yeah, it would be really good. Get the skeletons right away.
They're trying to bring down Radiant's top tower.
Look at my mana. My mana is amazing.
Radiant's top tower just got sent to the bottom.
You need to be with your team there on top lane. Like, these creeps don't do that much damage, but there's four of them that you can go high ground. Another problem is that these two people are going high ground, or three people, and they might just die now. One's about to defend, but like, you still have two tier 4 towers in the middle. It's not urgent to defend there. Now they're getting killed there, presumably.
Radiant's top barracks have fallen.
Okay, we're just defending. We have a buyback as well, so
Dire's bottom tower
can't afford to die. Okay, profit. Yeah, that's a good use of a harpoon. Alright, use the last man for Manta Style is good. I think you go back to Fountain quickly there.
Dire's bottom barracks are under attack.
He's solo on mana. Ooh, that's very nice. They can spread those out. Send like one each to the side lanes. Ah, don't let them die like this. Poor illusions. Can't really chase this. Like, illusion runes last for a long time, so you can send them to the side lanes. You can get a lot done with those.
Radiant's
middle tower can't handle this deluge.
Maybe not the most important use of mana there.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
Yeah, you get some mangoes, that's fine. I'm in good. But also actually just get the upgrade for your blink dagger. I guess you don't have that much surplus, okay. Yeah, saving Babic is important at this stage. Really important. If they bought back here, you should not push. They're 5. Don't even have Aegis, anything like that. Yeah, just push out the waves. Yeah, they're really coming to a fight in the middle there, so... yeah, I guess that's a decent choice to go back. I think I would have probably stayed up in bottom lane, but... maybe this is even better. It's a bit of a hard fight though. Do have buyback. Coming in. She probably doesn't have buyback, right? Yeah, hold on still. Yeah, so we need to stay here, fight, and use buyback if necessary. Oh, we bought out, we don't have buyback anymore. Ooh, this could be dicey. Now we have it. You already went so back so far, just go back to the fountain and get your mana back. You're playing with no mana the entire time. Alright, now we can... Well, I mean, there's only 2 dead. We have no mana, like anyone, so... Ooh, I'm gonna get that, get Arcane Rune. At low cooldown Manta. Is Roshan up? Anyway, we're going high ground here. I mean, there's 2 dead still. Without any mana, it's kind of hard. You need to go back now, they're gonna respawn soon. And you do have the Dragon Knight, that's kind of neat. This is risky high ground push, this is how you throw games. This is a Windlace, wow. Yeah. Good fight because we're ahead, but... Would have been much safer just to go for the next Roche. Now definitely time to disengage here. We just TP home. Yeah, nice. Right, we get those boots of travel. can almost afford Wizard Travel too. I don't know why we're here. Makes not too much sense to fight here outside of our home ground.
Dire's bottom barracks are under attack.
The survivor is forced out. Now we can get by Roots of Travel 2 as well. We have to sort of hit what we can. We'll use Miscall to get rid of the skeletons. Alright, got him. Trying to rat. Nice, we got him. And that should be game. Game goes on for another 30 minutes. Oh, they got the megas. What? How'd they get megas? Oh, okay, we bought back for the megas, okay.
I'm hungry enough to eat one of those.
Truly a one-track mind.
Guys, quite interested in you. Right, pushing out with the Illus. Good, good, good. I think you should go high ground now, not go for the Roshan. This is also a decent choice. Okay, this guy gets the Aegis and then decides to suicide. Okay. Interesting choice. We sold the Radiance. What kind of evasion do they have? I mean, just this, right? Honestly, I think I'd rather keep the Radiance and like disassemble it into like a rapier. Like that 20% evasion? Oh, there's also evasion like from the trees. Do you have that talent? No, he doesn't. I'm just gonna have it eventually. Like, if you have Rapier, you also have like Miscall is gonna do a lot more damage. So you can use Miscall to just clear megas decently well. Why do we have all this vision in this space? There's no wards here. I'm confused. Okay, now it's normal again. right. Need to go after the invoker. You got the mirror shield for even more tankiness. Okay. We also have almost megas. Okay. We just need to go after the Rax here. I don't like you running away here. We're gonna have buyback cooldown, but still. Okay, I guess we're winning this fight.
So long.
Just like your
ship. Okay, I don't think you want to fountain dive here. Hit the objectives. Okay, that was good. How is the game not over here? Oh, it just didn't move forward, this thing? Okay. We did it. Okay. Yeah, so like nice comeback just because enemy team just goes high ground stupidly. Yeah, that's just like a lesson. Just don't go high ground unless you have like a big advantage. Because it usually goes wrong. Well, that's like the easiest way of like throwing a game that you're winning, basically. Okay. Never go high ground, yes. So I'll tell you what, I think we're just gonna end the stream here. Only played one game, and that one was not the greatest, but also feeling a little bit under the weather. Do I watch Dark Matter? I watched him like back in a long time ago, like 15 years ago, 20 years ago. So yeah, we're gonna call it here. Next stream is gonna be on Saturday, not on Friday, but on Saturday. So 2 days hence, we shall stream some more and also play some ranked. I was 15 years old then. Maybe 20 years is a bit too much. No, I said 10 or 15, yeah, 15 years ago, I think is realistic. Yeah, anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you again on Saturday. Good.